You know what it means to take on yourself a mitzvah? It's not to say, from tomorrow I'm going to be in yeshiva for 3 hours. Every day. It's to say, you know what, I'm going to take on myself that every time that I say a bracha, first of all, every time that I eat something, I say a bracha. Most people, you know, they miss here and there. And when I say the bracha, I don't say it on autopilot. You know, I have to say the bracha, you have to hold what you're about to say the bracha in your right hand, you have to look at it. You have to say in your mind, okay, what is this? This is soda. What's the bracha? Shakol. Okay, what's happening now? I'm not joking. What's happening now when I'm about to say the bracha? There's a godly spark in this water, and I'm going to release it, and then I'm going to take this water and drink it, and this water is going to give me energy. And by doing all this, I'm doing what I'm supposed to do in the creation. Now, you don't have to make a whole ordeal out of it. It takes you 3 seconds to meditate. And when you meditate on your bracha, you don't even understand how powerful your bracha becomes. You cannot even understand how powerful it is. Taking yourself a mitzvah again, it's taking yourself saying, okay, you know what, from tomorrow, I'm going to put every day a quarter in a kupat tzedakah, in a charity box. Every day, no questions, I have a dollar, I don't have a quarter. And once a week, once a month, I'm going to give it away. I can give you now a list of mitzvot. If I were you, I would take like 100 of them. You know, when I had the opportunity to take on mitzvot, I would do them in pairs. Why should I do one? Let me do two. The reality is that the only way to get connected and to get blessing from Hashem is only if I come in and I create a channel. If I close the blinds, you can't expect Yeshuot. If you open the blinds, you get Yeshuot.
Rabbi, if you're on the phone with somebody and you say a bracha, can they answer amen?
Yeah. The only time they would not answer amen, first of all, if you hear a video, you don't answer amen. There is a safek through a speaker if you answer amen. I don't know if you had ever noticed, but in Orthodox weddings, usually the Rav that does the wedding pushes the microphone away. Because there's a doubt that if the Chatan and the Kala will hear his bracha and they have to be yotze with his bracha, but they'll hear it through the microphone, not through his voice, they didn't yotze in his bracha. I notice in many Orthodox weddings, the rabbi moves the microphone. He says it loud. There is a safek if you hear it through a microphone. There's a lot of dinim in it because this is something new. It's electronics and it's radio waves. But, you know, when radio waves started and they wanted in Reform shuls to say on Shabbat the brachot with a microphone, they said, yeah, there's no Chilul Shabbat here. There's no electricity here, no. So came all the Chachamim of that generation and says, no. In Shabbat, a radio wave that travels, that's Chilul Shabbat. That's why you're not allowed the microphone. The fact that the radio wave travels.